questions celebrate Halloween? Should they? We haven't seen the gospel yet. When I was growing up and when I was young in Washington, D.C., I went to a Seventh-day Adventist church. And they had a way to very powerfully focus your mind. And I said, it's sad many Christians go out and celebrate Halloween with masks made up of like devils, monsters. And it's disgusting. People put on their Christian masks. And that's disgusting. So please, when I was at Gallaudet, I accepted Christ at the age of 21. I received grace. And I look back on the Seventh-day Adventists and their emphasis on the laws. The Baptists explain the meaning of grace. Christians learn and from their mistakes, and when they fall, you help them to get back up again. The Seventh-day Adventists say you need to be punished, and they would kick you out of the church. But I've learned that it's best to repent. So, this is important. You may think that you understand, but you're not paying attention to the English word. The dictionary, the definition is important. The word Halloween, notice the separation here. Halloween means hallowed or holy. Christmas tradition as given was holy. Without any wine, the Eastern custom was to drink wine. In America, that was not permitted. And so people were not permitted to celebrate Christmas. You could have parties. And in the Lutheran church, people were permitted to drink wine, but until Christmas tree tradition was established. And then people gave gifts. Would get together and people's name, you forget about the wars. And then until I moved to Washington, D.C., I went to school, and a girl, age 11, asked me, "Are you from China?" Long ago, people were tall and they had slanted eyes. I learned it. There's something about history from that little girl. So you have God on one side of the gulf and people on the other side, separated by sin. Adam and Eve, when God created them, were without sin. And they had complete fellowship with God. They had no disease, no pain. But what happened? Adam and Eve fell into sin. Was it their fault? Was it Eve's fault? Well, many people blame Eve, but Eve was not evil. She had a mental weakness. Some people think she was simple-minded. But Satan, the spirit that she couldn't see, entered into the serpent and said, "If you eat, you know, this fruit is forbidden." And she said, "No, we are permitted to eat of all the trees except for one in the middle, called the knowledge of good and evil. If you eat of that, you will die." And Satan said, "Oh, really? No. If you eat of that, then you will be different. You will know right and wrong. And you will be like a god." Now, if you are a child of God, and God tells you to stop stealing, if you're on the job and you're late, "Well, I had a flat tire. Don't blame me. You could get fired." But Eve ate of the fruit and she suffered spiritual death, separation from God. Satan deceived her. She ate the fruit and she committed a sin. And immediately she was separated from God. And the angel had to kick her and her husband out of the Garden of Eden. And there was darkness in the world. Adam was probably saying, "I wish I had never listened to this woman." He had become an egotist. But he took her as his wife and they went out into the world. He saw the animals. Learned all about them. So I took history in college and projected a slide of a caveman. Now, I'm not talking about evolution, but this was a fact. There were people in caves who were very skilled at art in France. You know, they could see the cave art. And you can see the bison and the animals that they painted on the wall. So. There are also pictures of people wearing animal masks. And this is about Halloween. But out of the world, they had experience when you start smoking. Sin now has you get rid of it. Ask your friends. It's like a tick as an image of sin. You go to church and you take communion. But who can cleanse you spiritually? Only God can remove that sin. And so this sin, this taint, was passed on throughout the generations. Origins date back to the ancient festival of Samhain, which I'll explain later what that means. The Celts, who lived 2,000 years ago, so the Celts were some tribes in America. Tribes like the Cher, the ones who lived in the southeast. So, in Europe, there were also tribes, the Celts and the Franks and the Norse. So, how many of you are descended from Celtic? Yes. Anybody else? Irish? If you're Irish, you know, sometimes they were wild hearts, but they were able to draw animals. And they drew a picture of a man with an animal mask. And they would build bonfires and they would dance around the fires and celebrate. They were skilled at that. But when it became more about nudity and dancing, then it became sin. You know, so you see, this is a picture here. I didn't know this, that what's behind. When you join, my son graduated from KU, and he saw some Wiccans. Women who join the Wiccans must be highly educated. celebrated their new year on November 1st. It's called All Saints Day. The ancient Celtic people and the Druid priests worshipped Samhain, the Lord of Darkness, about 2,000 years ago. So we're not talking about Halloween yet. But the Druids and the Celts celebrated this. They weren't celebrating Halloween, but they would get together and pray for the dead. And then later, when Halloween appeared, the traditions were joined together. So this is Samhain. Question, should Christians celebrate Halloween? So I'll explain no, and then I'll explain the yes position. There are biblical verses against the Lord of Darkness, or Samhain, in Ephesians 5, chapter 5, verses 7 and 12. No partakers with those who are opposed to God's light. Those who are in the darkness, you know, they may celebrate with skulls and symbols of evil, and they may be witches. Witches parents' responsibility to say, use your judgment. Is it helpful to the Holy Spirit? You know, I can't tell you legalistically what to do. In the Old Testament, it's very strict. Moses commanded the Israelites when they lived in Egypt, they had learned a lot of Egyptian culture and customs. In Deuteronomy 18, verse 9 through 13. God is disgusted. For example, do not offer your sons or daughters as a sacrifice in the fire. The god Moloch was an idol. There was a priest of Moab, okay, when the child was born, parents who worship Moab. They would take their child and go up the steps to his fire, which was in the belly of the idol. And they would pray to the idol and drop the baby into the fire. Would you support this? You understand? The baby is innocent. It went to heaven, but do we still do that today? We don't worship Moloch anymore. But you can see on TV as you're driving, and you can see as you're driving by, billboards for Planned Parenthood. And they support abortion. So that women can go in and get friendly, helpful nurse or doctor will be understanding. You have to be very careful with the person who says, oh yes, I understand, because they might be stupid. And so, women have abortions today. Politicians say it's the people's will, but does God support that? That will bring a curse for God. Third, turn away from divination. Go to someone who uses a crystal ball or a tarot reader and says they'll prophesy the future. You know, when you get married, when you have kids. But prophecy of that nature is Satan's voice, not God's. You must be blameless before the Lord your God. So blameless blameless does not mean perfect. You want to be a deacon or an elder or Sunday school teacher, and you are recommended and people vote on you. You must be blameless. Anything you may have done in the past, God has forgiven you. And so you can be a pastor or a Sunday school teacher. And there are many people who practice witchcraft who have crystal balls and tarot cards. And they have all these symbols. things that we need to avoid. So what should you do about Halloween? Now, look at the picture here. Who is this here? The person. Right. Dracula. As I've been reading, David Hansen was part of a group who flew to Romania. And there are pictures of this man who has they were greeted by a man who resembled the picture of Dracula. He said, "May I dance with you?" He danced very gracefully. And once that gets planted in your mind, you go, and the sun goes down. And the legend of Dracula is that he becomes a bat and sucks your blood. You see the pumpkin over here and the ghost. Today, adults still set up decorations. And they dress up and the kids come by like a ghost or a witch. And the kids say, "Mommy, I want to be like that." And so the parents get into them and they buy them these costumes. And when they grow up, they become witches or wizards. Ephesians chapter 5, verse 11. "Have nothing to do with the unfruitful works of darkness." So, Paul says, if this is bad, have nothing to do with it. Avoid it. In 1 Thessalonians 5:22, abstain, avoid all appearance of evil. The decision is yours, but if you make a mistake, if you err, wouldn't it be better to err on the side of caution and godliness? So this means that if you're wrong, if you have a clean heart, if you're saved, and you change from what you were before, should Christians celebrate Halloween? This is the no answer. Now, let's look at the yes. And we'll look at the yes later. The satanic druids want you to honor the Halloween festival in Samhain's name. Center of world trade, with philosophy, psychology, history, education, and people tended to say, I know it. They didn't like religion telling them what to do. Gospel on Halloween night. So instead of carving a scary pumpkin face, they say, oh, that looks great. That looks like a devil. Or that looks like a vampire. Or that looks like a beast. I like this. I love with this. so you can, you can win contests by carving pumpkins with Christmas trees. You can put gospel messages in the pumpkins. For example, John 3:16, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, and people can pull out the gospel message and make a game of it. So that you can go ahead and do. You can take your pumpkin, and that way you can do a positive encouragement. So Halloween, October 31st, you can be creative. And this is good. You can learn about parables. Parable of the seeds. Celebrate harvest, and you can decorate with pumpkins, scoop out the pumpkins, and use the parable of the seeds. Have you ever heard the parable of the seeds? And that way you can spread the gospel. Instead of just saying that Halloween is bad, use it as an opening. First parable is about the man who sowed seeds. And as he was sowing, some of the seeds fell by the wayside. They fell beside the road, and so what happened to those seeds? The birds came along. They were watching for their chance. And so they waited after the sower left. And then they came and flew down. And they picked up the seeds that fell by the wayside and ate them. The birds are a picture of Satan. The seeds are God's words. So when you hear God's words, Satan comes in immediately and tries to distract you, tries to get you not to study the Bible and to forget what you learned. The second is the rock. Rock where he threw the seeds, some of it landed on rocks. And it began to grow. The roots could not grow deep enough. So the sun beat down on it, and without any water, it began to wilt. So what does that mean? When you go to church, you may be inspired by the sermon, and then once you leave, distracted by girls, by smoking, by dancing, by drinking. You go back to your old life. When the Word of God takes root in your heart. Third is the thorns. Thorns are when you accept salvation, you grow in these, and then say you get a job, you're out in the world, Monday through Sunday, you're working, and you get rich. Famous, you get successful. You work your way up to the president of the company. Maybe you're a millionaire. And you're still saved. And the story of Jesus has its roots, but the weeds have grown up. Kids might ignore it while your father out, but once they get home, they might be curious and read the track. So which is better here? The right or the left? Which is better? You're saying the right. How do you know? Really? If you choose Jesus, but in the back of your mind, God's wife. Thank you for advising me. I choose Jesus. Here, you can't see beyond the fire. Bonfires, and the figures were made of wood, and people would stand around like the Druids would worship in their hooded robes. sweatshirts. Walk around like a gang member. So now you can read the scripture here. So I'm going to sign this for you. I'm going to condense it a little bit. Verse 21. And verse 22. And then verse 23. Right, your imagination. Going back to when man first rebelled against God and the gulf of sin opened between man and God. He was cast out of the garden into the world. He had to make his home. He had to learn about the animals. And as he learned about them, his imagination began to develop. The Druid priests with their robes who spoke to the spirits. A spirit named Samhain. And once he began celebrating Halloween, it came from their imagination. But we make mistakes as well. Because we think that we are good enough without God. We don't need God. So that's number 22. Professing themselves to be wise, they became fools. They changed the glory of the incorruptible God into an image like to corruptible man, and to birds and creeping things. So they made idols. This is exactly like Halloween. The creeping things. So they made masks to resemble the animals. Like the priests of Moloch casting the infants into the fire. Corruptible man. Glory of God, which they changed to man's wisdom. And they put on a mask. Karl Marx. be lagging on Halloween, but then they have to get up the next morning and go to school, and it's boring. They celebrate, and then the next morning, they've got to get up and go to work. So, eternal life is salvation. You see the red cross, it's like a bridge, right? If you didn't have that bridge, could you run across that gap? You couldn't. When you're under stress and pressure from on iniquities are gone to my head as a heavy burden, they are too heavy for me. I have to ask God to take those sins from me, take my sins on His shoulders. That is what we have to do, but is it? Some of you, then, after a party, I listen to men and women who have to work, whose responsibility is to clean up after the party. You should be respectful of them. Responsibility is to work hard. Your pastors have a great burden for all of you. And as you get older, when you ask for help, when they ask if they can help you, you should accept their help. You know, if I'm a deacon and I'm a pastor, I'm still a servant. I have a family. I serve them. I have a job. I have to work and serve there. I have a church. I serve there. So that's three areas of service. And if I have sin of all the world, I'm just one person. possible to pinball on Halloween. Use Halloween to tell the parable of the sower and the seeds. And they shall see his face. And his name shall be in their forehead. No more faces of the Halloween world. Like the superhero costumes, Captain America. There won't be any in heaven. With their hair dyed purple. There will be none of that with Jesus. As we struggle those may excite us for a while, but then we still have our struggles. Maybe you quit your job, divorce, stop going to church. Foolish. His name shall be in their forehead. Remember, Adam and Eve were separated from God. They had to learn about the world. Where was God's name? Instead, they were angry. Had to kill. And they might have felt suicidal, like slitting their wrists. So you compare earthly suffering. The spiritual suffering is worse. But Jesus suffered the suffering that we have on earth is temporary. In heaven, we will see Jesus' face. It'll be much more beautiful than Halloween. Father in heaven, this morning, the title of my sermon is, Should Christians Celebrate Halloween? The Bible warns us against darkness. Again, and in the name of Sam Hain, but your name is greater. You have more power than Sam Hain. Moses taught the Israelites not to worship idols. You have given them wisdom and intelligence and new character to teach children on earth to work hard, to build better homes, be better parents, and better build better governments. Dancing and celebrating doesn't profit anything. But Satan and all his works will be destroyed. And that many politicians bow down to the people who don't care about you. They care only about themselves. And Hollywood actors. between parties. We prefer to fellowship with people like us. If there is no God, we are wasting our time. The people of the world don't care. They're stubborn. They refuse our help. Just like Noah, who preached and warned the people for over 120 years, that they were stubborn and refused to listen. It's not a waste of time. Help us to keep doing it. Jesus will never leave us. We pray and we weep because we have no courage. We're afraid because the world overwhelms us. Satan is all around us. Struggle. As we sang this morning, we are in a war. Help us to make a stand. Because Jesus is alive. He has overcome death. And we have victory in Christ. There is no shame. I pray for strength. I pray that October 31st we'll be able to help those of us who come to our celebration. In Jesus' name, amen. We're dismissed.